Hi, my name is Chris and this is Battle Nonsense. When I first tested PUBG and Fortnite, I was quite shocked to find out that their servers are only able to send 8 updates per second to the players. Or in other terms, that they were running at a tick rate of just 8 Hz during the early stages of the match, as the load created by 100 players just was too much for the Unreal Engine at that time. This low tick rate then led to a lot of network delay or lag, as well as issues with the hit registration, which caused a bad online experience for the players. But during the last few months, Epic worked very hard on optimizing the Unreal Engine for games that have that many players. And so Fortnite, as well as any other Battle Royale game that uses the enhancements shipped with the Unreal Engine 4.19 update, should now be able to achieve a tick rate of at least 20 Hz, even when all 100 players are still alive. If you want to know more about the bad state that the game was in when I first tested it, and how those networking and server enhancements affected the network delay, then you can find links to my Fortnite and PUBG netcode analysis videos in the description down below. Now, while the developers of PUBG still haven't merged the networking and server enhancements of the Unreal Engine 4.19 update, which means that their server's tick rate is still just 8 Hz during the early stages of the match, Epic Games seems to be pushing for an even higher tick rate than 20 Hz. After the release of the 4.0 patch, players who enabled the network stats overlay noticed that during the pre-round phase, the server would sometimes send more than 50 updates per second to the player instead of just 20, and that was while there were already more than 90 players connected to the server. However, as soon as the match began, the server's update rate went back to 20 Hz. At the time, my theory was that the developers simply disabled the 20 Hz limit just during the pre-round phase so that they could gather data on how the servers handle higher rates and what rates the servers can achieve. But to ensure that players got a consistent network delay and so a consistent online experience, they enabled the 20 Hz limit as soon as the match began. Now, right after patch 4.1 dropped earlier this week, some servers didn't seem to have the 20 Hz limit enabled, as during the match the server continued to send more than 30 updates per second to the players, which you can see here in this gameplay and here in the network capture from Wireshark. So I did a few quick tests and noticed that on the day patch 4.1 dropped, about 4 out of 10 servers did not have their tick rate locked at 20 Hz. So I got very excited as I thought that Epic was slowly rolling out that change to all servers, and I planned to run more network delay tests the next day. Sadly, on the next day I had to find out that all servers had that 20 Hz lock enabled again when the match began. I tried solo, duo, squad and infinity gauntlet mode, but after I tried more than 25 different servers, it became clear that besides an occasional spike here and there, all servers were back at 20 Hz. I guess that the servers were never intended to run at more than 20 Hz when the match began. Maybe there was a bug in the server build which caused that the limit didn't kick in, or maybe the servers were not configured correctly and that's why the 20 Hz limit didn't kick in after the pre-round phase. But whatever caused this, it seems that Epic has fixed it now. But why should you even care if the servers run at 20 Hz or more? Let's take Battlefield 1 on PC as example, where the server runs at a tick or simulation rate of 60 Hz and so sends 60 packets per second to the player, which means that you get a new data packet about every 16 milliseconds. If Fortnite would run at 30 Hz, then we would get an update every 33 milliseconds, so half as many as you get in Battlefield 1 on PC. But right now it runs at just 20 Hz, which means that there is even more time between two updates, 50 milliseconds to be exact. So, while 20 Hz is not exactly great for a first-person shooter, it's a big improvement from what we had before the network and server enhancements, where the server would only send you 8 updates per second, which meant 125 milliseconds between two updates. PUBG players are still suffering from this, as Bluehole did not merge the Unreal Engine 4.19 changes yet. So, when the server sends data more frequently, then this reduces the network delay as there is less time between the updates. As a result, the game feels more responsive and you don't take damage that far behind cover unless you get shot by a player who has a very high ping, as higher update and tick rates can't fix the player's ping. More about that in my Fortnite netcode analysis videos that I link to in the description down below. But higher tick and update rates do not only reduce the network lag, they also mitigate how severely packet loss impacts your online experience, since when the server sends 60 updates per second, then it hurts much less when 3 packets don't reach the client than when this happens at lower rates. So while it is very unfortunate that the Fortnite servers only briefly ran at more than 20 Hz, having seen that the servers are able to maintain more than 30 Hz even when there are 100 players on the server gives me hope that Epic Games will soon be able to bump that tick rate from 20 to 30 Hz in the near future, and then also ship these enhancements with one of the next Unreal Engine updates for other games to benefit from as well. So, even though I could not provide you with data on how that higher update rate affects the network delay, I hope that you still enjoyed this quick update video on what happened in Fortnite after the release of the 4.1 patch. As always, I will keep you updated on the progress that the developers make, and if you like what I am doing here on my channel, then it would be great if you could support me on Patreon, as YouTube's ad revenue is sadly not enough anymore to run a niche channel like mine. Without the awesome support that I get from my patrons, Battle Nonsense would not exist anymore, and I could not bring you that keyboard input lag analysis that I'm working on at the moment. You can find the link to my Patreon in the description down below, where you will also find links to my social accounts in case that you want to stay up to date on the videos that I'm working on. So if you enjoyed this video, then please give it a like, subscribe for more, and I hope to see you next time. Until then, have a nice day and take care. My name is Chris, and this was Battle Nonsense.